Hey y'all, so today we're gonna work with paper mache. Most of you know I love paper mache. I think it is such a cool way to build things really easily with materials you have at home. So what you need for this project is baseline. You just need newspaper torn up into chunks that are roughly like, or strips, pieces that are 1 inch by 2 inch around this size. Some sort of container. I'm using a 1 gallon milk jug, but you can also use like lemonade containers or whatever you've got on hand. And then the other thing you'll need is that paste that we made. Remember, it's like half and half water and flour, and also a little bit of salt to keep it from going bad. That's all you need. If you want, or if you're able, you can add details to the container using cardboard and attaching the cardboard with tape. What I'm going to create out of my container using paper mache is a fun face, sort of like a sculptural head, and I'll show you the finished result at the end. So to paper mache, you're going to set your container on a base, and you'll do our paper mache the base like with the on a second round. We're gonna start by just paper macheing the stuff on the top, then letting that dry, and then you'll paper mache the base. So you'll want to make sure that there is moisture on both sides of each piece of paper so that each side is fully wet. There's no dry spots, but not that there's like a bunch of soupy stuff stuck on it. So it should be wet, fully wet, but not soaking. Then you'll make sure it lays totally flat on your container or whatever surface you're paper macheing on, and you keep going. You'll want to make sure that these papers slightly overlap, because when they overlap, that just makes it stronger, and it just makes sure that you don't have any spots that didn't get covered. On spots, if you did use cardboard, spots where cardboard meet your container, make sure that you get that seam, that pieces of paper mache strips go across the cardboard to the container. So when it dries, that seam gets nice and hard and they kind of fuse together and become one piece. I'll do a few more strips here, and then I will show you a finished result. You can use liquid starch instead of this flour and water mixture, and liquid starch is just a mixture of cornstarch, water, and soap, which I bet you can make yourself too. I'll look for a recipe, and if I find one, I'll put it on the blog post for this project. Ooh, ah! Here's a good point. Use a piece of newspaper as a placemat, because I'm getting all over my table, because I'm not nice. Keep it clean here, keep it tidy. Okay, take it nice and slow on areas that are more sculpted, like this area where the handle is. And if you need to tear pieces even smaller to kind of get in those little tricky areas, you can. I'll do that. I tore a strip in half so it's a little skinnier, so I can get that little weird area. Yeah. Okay. So go ahead, paper mache the whole thing except for the bottom so it can dry, get hard, and then once it's dry, then you can paper mache the bottom and set it on its side while the bottom dries. So I'm going to set that aside for now and show you a finished piece. So let's say you finished paper macheing it, it's all dry, it looks something like zoop, this. I went ahead and added a layer of gesso onto mine, which is like a white primer paint that just sort of covers up the newspaper. You can buy gesso, but I'll also attach in the blog a homemade recipe for gesso. You don't have to gesso it. If you want to cover up the newspaper, other options of doing that is using either white paper or a brown paper bag and tearing strips of that and adding a layer of paper mache using that instead of newspaper. And that will at least give you one solid color instead of newspaper print. So, here's my character that I made. It's kind of like a cute troll. I used paint, and I used right here is the stuff from like a bag of oranges. These are magazine papers that I rolled around my finger to kind of create a nice curl that I made the eyelashes out of and the hair. If you don't have paint, honestly, these are the most interesting parts, the things that I made out of found materials at home. So you can just cover the entire sculpture that you make with found materials that aren't paint. I love papier-mâché. And in a future video, I'll show you some masks that I made that I can actually wear. And that's an option too if you've got a lot of time on your hands and some cardboard and flour and newspaper. Yeah.